Welcome back once again. I have another Krieg kind of build playing around with here. Similar to the last build, I took advice from some people that left comments, and I switched. Oops. Basically, I took elemental empathy away because, well, I don't know how that's going to work. So I took this away. I wasn't really doing much fire damage, but it does work with shock dots. And I went with salt the wound instead, and then I switched to a meat com. Now, some people have recommended I use the barbarian comms instead because the passive boost on it are better, which is true. But embrace the pain is actually useful, and the other two had two skills that were going to do nothing. I forgot the other two skills it boosted. And because I'm trying to do this really without relying on just holding a grog, or I have the kittens there, but I'm trying to mainly use the twister, the health regen actually comes in handy. And then I'm also going to try wearing a Blood of the Seraphs for even more health stacking. Not quite as much as, where is it? The Bloods would do. I thought I had a Blood on me. But I also get health regen. It's only 1% a second, but this combined with this, combined with Embrace the Pain, I'm hoping is enough to keep me alive, including the damage reduction from numb nerves. So we will see how all that works in practice here. I have a feeling I was getting a decent amount of healing from that, from the shock dots. I know on like BL2skills.com it says burn only, but in here it says all elemental effect dots. So yeah, I'm gonna see if this works or not. It might be a total bust. I honestly haven't even tried it yet. But salt the wound. So I not only have 5 out of 5 in bloodbath, which wasn't proccing all the time, and I was destroying enemies without slag or without that anyways. But now with this, 220% shotgun damage when I get up to 11 stacks will almost probably equate almost to the same damage this was doing, just because I'm increasing my base damage so much. So, yeah, we are going to see how all that works. I'm full on ammo. Let's see, what's my grenade? I'm gonna Slag transfusion. I should build up stacks fast enough. And so far, this is not working well. Yeah, I'm not getting nearly the healing I was. But I can always just throw more grenades, because they are going to be plentiful. The damage is still there. I mean, for sure the damage is definitely there, but I am kind of missing. The whoa. Well, that was big. Oh, that was my transfusion grenade that healed me. So with this, as long as I keep the enemies close, it doesn't seem too bad. But out in actual gameplay, there's gonna be more of a gap to close. And I don't know how that's gonna work. I still have the Reaper comm I plan on using in my backpack. Definitely for team play, because that team skill duration is pretty awesome. It's one of, I think it's one of the coolest team skill abilities out there. So maybe this isn't that bad. I just had that early downing before I had all my stuff going. That's part of also what makes Krieg tough in co-op play, is you kind of got to get them going, and when you're fighting for kills with other people, It's not always the easiest thing in the world. So I definitely don't need more damage. It is kind of on this healing. Yeah, I'm getting crazy damage from the Twister here. With those skills procced and going up there. Although I am starting to run out of ammo, so I don't know. I don't think this is quite doing as good as I hoped. And the other ones, oh, there's ammo. I was not running into low ammo as much. And I was killing a lot more enemies in a single shot. So the salt of the wound isn't doing quite what I hoped it did. And I think 10 out of 5 thrill out of the kill. I mean, I went down a lot in my healing here, but, you know, I am staying alive. Maybe I'm just a little more paranoid about watching my health here. That was just terrible. Point blank shots just missing like crazy. Oh, there's a down. Now to strike your face from my fingernails. Oh, there's another one. So another relic I have in here, I don't know how that's going to work. I have a damage reduction skin of the ancients. Oh, that's not what I want to do. Because I've got, like, no melee skills. This is going to go good. Oh, I stayed alive, so that's all that matters. Alright, so I'm still one-shotting those dudes if they're slagged. Or I can. So there's some blood explosion. I haven't got many good chains during this like I did last time, though. Slag him. It hurts. It hurts. Why are salt the wound? Just am I killing guys too fast to get stacks of that? Also not getting on fire very well. The other build, I had more ways to make sure I got on fire better. And I was on fire more often, and that helped as well. So maybe I am better off with a Reaper comm. Just regularly. I'm not really seeing an advantage to this comm. So I guess I could try it with the Reaper comm in this setup and see if Thrill the Kill there is enough to get me over, and I'll still have 5 points in Salt the Wound as well. We'll see, but the way I dig this, after I kind of get this down a little better, I'm going to take this build out in the wild more, get out of Pete's bar with it, and see how it performs there, because this isn't the best, really the best test of a build. It does test certain aspects of it, but I'm thinking this actually makes it a little easier for me, since it's so condensed with enemies, I can keep hitting them and I won't have to close any gaps. But, I don't know yet. But that's certainly a lot of dead bodies, and let me know what you guys think. But yeah, I'm not really sold on this, so maybe I go back to the Legendary Reaper. And, man, do I just go with this? I wonder if this will be enough. Because, yeah, I don't really need Burn Baby Burn, because I'm not really using fire damage. But this should definitely help having more elemental effects out there. And that should help get Elemental Elation, which I really wasn't getting during that one. And then I still have 10 out of 5 here, 10 out of 5 there. And, yeah, you know what? I might as well give it a try. And yeah, my Krieg's name is Maya, and my Maya's name is Brick. So I'll have quite a bit less health, but I still have a lot of health. Yeah, so far this is already kind of thinking this is going to be better. Yep, this is feeling way better. Well, I'm not getting many Salt the Wound stacks, because everything's dying too fast. But I definitely like the Thrill the Kill bonus. And I'm definitely on fire more often. Although, do I have Elemental Elation even going? Oh. Sorry, I was kind of looking at my stuff there and not really concentrating on the kill. Probably going to go down again there. Why is that not even proccing? When I'm on fire, it shouldn't go away. I have this. I guess Pain is Power is the better one anyways, but... Interesting. Yeah, I definitely feel more survival with this setup. That throw less grenades too, which is good. Although there, I'm gonna throw a few, cause I had a distance to get cover, and I'd rather save my grenades for when I need to cover distance and just always throw. Yeah, to me, a big part of the fun of this game is not using Moxie weapons. I know a lot of people love them, and Moxie weapons are cool, but I hate relying on them to stay alive and constantly swapping to a non-DPS gun. Because when you do that, you are doing less damage, because you're swapping from your primary damage dealer. Like, not if you're Sal, of course. But, you know, as Maya, I love Life Tap, because I can just keep shooting my Pimpernel. I don't have to stop doing damage to switch to another gun to heal. Like you often have to do with other characters, or like, I see that a lot of times B-Hawk players, there's nothing wrong with the B-Hawk, but I see them getting overrun a lot because they just keep switching to the Grog and throwing chain lightnings to heal, and then they're not putting out any damage, and eventually they just die because they're not killing anything. There's Elemental Elation. But it's not stacking. Do I just get rid of that skill and do another skill? If I'm not getting anything out of it without the Flame of the Firehawk going off. Yeah, that was my fault. I should have thrown that earlier. So I'm not going to put that on the setup. Yep, this is definitely working a lot better. So, I just don't know why this isn't proccing. That is weird, but if I pull out those 5 points, where would I put them? I'm not going to go melee, so I don't need that. All these other skills are kind of wasted. I'm not going to really use that. I don't know where else I would put those points. Fire breath. I also don't know why it's not proccing. It should. So I'm on fire now. Definitely. Are things just dying too fast to get a dot? I wonder. I guess, I mean, in chat or in comments, if you know. I'm mainly asking myself these questions. I talk to myself and think aloud. I think that's the case. Everything's just dying in one shot, so I'm not getting any dots out there. That was pretty nice. Yep, I think that's exactly it. But I think I'm narrowing down on the build. I like this setup here. I'll still have to play around with relics. I don't know how much I really need the deputy's badge here. There might be a better relic for me. Aww. You know, maybe with thrill of the kill, just a shock bone would be better. There's also one of those Seraph relics that you return some health on a kill to get me more health. Maybe that would be better than the health regen. Or maybe a Blood of Terra, which isn't going to increase my health at all. It's just going to give me a higher health regen passive than the other one. Or, of course, there's always a Skin of the Ancients. Just give me all sorts of damage reduction on top of my Rough Rider and Fire Fiend. That might not be a bad idea. I kind of like the idea of using relics that aren't as commonly used. I totally did not need Slag on him, but screw it. So yeah, I think I'm narrowing this down. I definitely think that second run went a lot better. So yeah, that makes it good because I like the Reaper for co-op anyways. The Deputy Badge, it helped. I don't know if it's necessary, but yeah, here's what I was thinking of. Skin of the Ancients, I don't know if that's a perfect one. I wish they could come without the shield stuff, and I could just get like Fire, Corrosive, Explosive, and Non-Elemental. Yeah, I'll keep playing around with the relics here. I think I've got everything set except the relic. The Deputy's Badge is definitely good. The extra damage is a nice addition. This would be more, but I don't need the cooldown. And yeah, it's definitely more damage. Krieg does have a lot of reload speed skills, so maybe I don't need that. So I guess my next test I do might be with this. Because more overkill damage is more health and more healing. And it's the least, I need Slag least. Jesus. I will need less Slag with it. I don't think I need a Stormfront to stack. My stacks were getting up high enough fast enough. And I could throw a Stormfront or two and then run in and switch my grenade. But that, again, I don't like going into my menus mid-combat. I don't really enjoy that either. But yeah, so far I'm getting to a build that looks pretty effective. And like I said, I did the peak with this with four player. Just, you know, switched around a few. I didn't switch to my kittens at all there. So that was pretty decent. Went down a few times that second run. Maybe it was just once, which was kind of my fault. I wasn't really paying attention. So yeah, maybe I will go try like Bloodshot or the Assassins with this. The Assassins would be interesting because there's some tough enemies there to kill. And kind of test it further, and then I can really narrow down which relics will be best for it. So once again, thanks for watching. Comment below to let me know what you think about the quick change in the build and, you know, just different relics you guys have ideas of. I don't think I'm going to do a Barbarian comm. I think I'm going to stay with the Legendary Reaper. But I'm really still up for finding the perfect relic for this, because I don't think a Shock Bone is it. I don't think the Deputy's Badge, although the Deputy's Badge is good, the Shock Bone is good. I don't know if those are the perfect relics. I like a good tank relic. So yeah, let me know what you think below on all that, and if you have not yet subscribed, please do that. I also appreciate when you share the videos. I am trying to grow my channel. I'm fairly new at doing this. And thanks for watching. I will see you all later. Bye.